Okay, so SEO season 3 has arrived, y'all, and I enjoyed it. Very much so. And, you know, I gotta come out and say, SEO has taken on a whole new, I guess, way of presenting itself in terms of actually diving into the VR world. And right off the rip, I know a lot of people may say, and or feel as if it kind of dragged at the beginning until really we got to see, I guess, until they got to the cave, essentially, Alice, Yu-Gi-Oh, and Kirito. And I did enjoy all that stuff. It is prologue. It's something that we're going to appreciate later. We're glad they set it up rather than just diving into adult Kirito. And I like how they had kid Kirito because now we have a foundation for a story. And that's really what I'm heading into. It feels as if, you know, Elysiasian, it really feels as if it has a storyline. Unlike GGO, unlike ALO and, of course, the Einkrad arc. Those felt as if it was more like a free roam, and it feels as if the show is going to have structure. It feels as if the game has its own storyline. It feels as if they're going through campaign mode and or storyline mode once again. That's what it feels like. It feels as if we're going to have structure this time, and that's something that really, truly excites me to see from Sword Art Online, personally. But other than that, though, fucking beautiful. The show looks amazing. It looks like a movie. Like it's taken an even bigger step within the world of Sword Art Online. I know. I didn't know if it's possible either. I did not know that was possible. But it feels as if I'm watching a movie, an animated movie. That's crazy. But I mean, hey, whenever you have Sword Art Online, Ordinal Scale come out, and it's literally one of the biggest, if not the biggest movie ever in terms of sales for tickets, well, then you probably got a pretty big fucking budget. But that's just me. But other than that, though, I did love the approach once again, and I appreciated the slow start because now we have a foundation to build upon. So the show also did a great job just to, in this first half of the first episode, kind of review. But it did a good job at least giving us Yu-Gi-Oh's eye, and or not Yu-Gi-Oh. Not Yu-Gi-Oh, Yu-Gi-Oh's. Yu-Gi-Oh's. Oh, gosh. If I say Yu-Gi-Oh, that's going to be terrible. It does not, Yu-Gi-Oh does not fit in the SAO world. But nonetheless, I did enjoy the eye part because now it has a question. Ask anybody. I always say this. Some of you guys that have been here for a while, listen. How do you start a paper? How do you start a story? Make your audience ask a question. Make them wonder something. If you don't have them wanting to ask a question, then they're not really engaged into where your story is going, and that makes me, you know, ask a question. And Kirito saying, it's as if your soul gets transferred into the game. It's as if you are really a part of a world rather than actually just being in the game. I know VR feels real, but this feels like this is my life. This is where I belong. And maybe that's also because once you leave the game, you don't retain your memories. You only get your memories back once you go back into the game, back into the storyline. And that's pretty cool to see because it's just like, hey, look, I don't have the same equipment I do in multiplayer mode as I do in campaign mode. Those are two separate worlds within the same world in and of itself, right? So that's kind of how I see it. I hope that you guys are able to like really comprehend that. But because I didn't necessarily describe it the best way, but nonetheless, I hope you guys understand what I'm saying there. But on top of that, though, I think the character designs for GGO, I'm glad that they showed all the characters in GGO, because those character designs were in-depth. They were really cool, really fun. I'm glad to see they're using the GGO arc once again, because it was the best-written arc, if we're going to get technical about it. I mean, actually gave Kirito characterization, seen on characterization, Kirito did development, scene on character development, and that's whenever the scene at the cafe, I really enjoyed that scene, because that's the big three of Sword Online. And I mean that from a writing standpoint. Those are the best three written characters in Sword Art Online. So, and they have the best kind of character interactions. I mean, especially Kirito and Sinon, they went through characterization, they went through character development together, and that's how their relationship was established. So that's why they have that good character chemistry, and that's why I'm glad to see it. I mean, the whole gun thing, and this is cool to see. Great character chemistry, that's good writing for those two characters. I mean, if anyone has good writing and great character chemistry, it's those three for sure. Of course, I love all the character chemistry. I mean, Klein is awesome, but those three have the best written, so we're able to really kind of, I guess, engage with those character interactions with those three. We're really able to understand why they act the way they do towards one another on a deeper level. So other than that, though, it is cool. Once again, I kind of said this a little bit, but it's cool to see that you can actually transport your life basically into the game, and or the game really is your other life. It's as if you live two lives, basically, is really what Kijito describes it. And they do go into depth saying, I was there for like 2 days, 3 days, and it felt like a month. I mean, and that's something that's really cool to think about that. If I could spend a whole year in a game, but it's only like 5 hours in the real world, holy shit. You know what I mean? It would truly feel as if I was in a different life. And if I was in a world with magic and whatnot and so on and so forth, I probably wouldn't even be in this reality. That would be the ultimate escapism. Like holy shit, that'd be the ultimate escape. I mean, that'd be nuts. Just think about that in real life. So maybe we're going to be able to relate to Kijito even more in a different way. I mean, not totally in a different way, but in a different way at the same time. You know, it's not just going into virtual reality, but truly feels like a different world. And that's something I can understand. And I'm going to understand where Kijito's coming from whenever he talks about it. So, yeah. But once again, the key here is storyline. And that's what it seems as if season 3 is going to have. But other than that, though, guys, Johnny Black did show up and he got stabbed at a thing that usually sends people into cardiac arrest. What happens now? Probably gets thrown in the machine. We can probably all guess that, right? I don't know what happens, but obviously he's going back to the machine, obviously. But the opening, that is something that I'm probably going to talk about next week's episode as well, because I don't know how many people made it to the end of the video. But the opening is a banger, man. Like, my fair opening, I love them all, first off. Mother Rosalia arc is probably the weakest opening out of all of them. GGO is a banging opening. Oh, but this one bangs. Remember, UGO and Kijito are like doing the sword swing and sync and stuff, and they do like the handshake and stuff. Their character relationship is gonna be awesome. It's gonna be amazing. It's gonna be like they're freaking like brothers or something. I don't even know. I'm so excited to see those two on screen, man, and I cannot wait. But other than that, though, it doesn't really get much better than this. This is what I've been waiting for. This is what I've been excited for. This is where I heard Sword Art Online takes a turn for the best and becomes something that is different from it's the title it's given now by a lot in the anime community. Of course, some love it, some hate it. Some people are on the middle. I'm someone that really enjoys Sword Art Online. I think it's amazing. I do see its flaws, though. You've seen my videos on it. There's people who've been here for a while. But other than that, though, guys, hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hope you guys enjoyed the opening of Sword Art Online. Definitely leave your thoughts on the opening. I'll see you guys next time. Peace. Thanks for watching, guys. Man, this fall season is fucking amazing.